Welcome to Morning Manna. My name is Ken Danson. I'd like to share with you a little bit from my devotion this morning. It's from Andrew Murray, None Can Teach Like Jesus, out of Mark 6:34. And Jesus, when he came out, saw a great multitude and was moved with compassion for them, because they were like sheep not having a shepherd. So he began to teach them many things. Jesus has opened a school in which he trains his redeemed ones, the ones who specially desire it, to have power in prayer. Let us enter in with this petition. Lord, it's just this that we need to be taught. Lord, teach us to pray. Dear Lord, we have read in your word with what power your believing people of old used to pray. And we have read about the mighty wonders that were done in answer to their prayers. And if this took place under the old covenant in the time of preparation, how much more will you, in these days of fulfillment, give your people this sure sign of your presence in their midst? We have heard the promises given to your apostles concerning the power of prayer, and we have seen how gloriously they experienced their truth. We hear continually about the glorious tokens of your power that you still give to those who trust you fully. Lord, we are like men of old, so teach us to pray like them. Your promises are for us, too, as the powers and gifts of the heavenly world. So teach us to pray so that we may receive abundantly. Yes, we feel the need now of being taught to pray. At first, there is no work that appears so simple. Later on, there are none that appears more difficult. So the confession is forced from us. We do not know how to pray as we should. It is true we have God's word with its clear and sure promises, but sin has so darkened our minds that we do not always know how to apply the word. In spiritual things, we do not always seek the most needful things. In temporal things, we do not always avail ourselves of the wonderful liberty our Father has given us, the liberty to ask for what we need. And even when we know what to ask for, much is still needed to make prayer acceptable. Our prayers must be to the glory of God, in full surrender to His will, in full assurance in the name of Jesus, in full assurance of faith in the name of Jesus, with a perseverance that, if need be, refuses to be denied. All this must be learned. It can only be learned in the school of much prayer, amid the painful consciousness of ignorance and unworthiness, in the struggle between believing and doubting. The heavenly art of effectual prayer is learned, and none can teach like Jesus. A pupil needs a teacher who knows his work, who has the gift of teaching, who in patience, love, and love will descend to the pupil's needs. Jesus is all this and much more. It is Jesus praying himself who teaches us to pray. He knows what prayer is. He learned it amid the trials and tears of his earthly life. In heaven, it is still his beloved work. His life there is prayer. Nothing delights Jesus more than to find those whom he can take with him into the Father's presence, whom he can clothe with the power to pray down God's blessing on those around him, whom he can train to be his fellow workers in intercession by which the kingdom is to be revealed on earth. He knows how to teach. By his Holy Spirit, he has access to our hearts and teaches us to pray by showing us the sin that hinders prayer and giving us the assurance that we please God. He teaches by giving not only thoughts of what to ask, but how to ask, but also by breathing within us the very spirit of prayer, by living within us as the great intercessor. Jesus never taught his disciples how to preach, only to pray. He did not speak much of preaching well. He spoke much of praying well. Knowing how to speak to God is more important than knowing how to speak to man. Not power with men, but power with God is the first thing. Jesus loves to teach us how to pray. Let's take a minute and pray now. Father, we come before you and we just thank you for your love. We thank you for your mercy. We thank you that you, Lord, draw us to you. And it's by the power of your Holy Spirit, Lord Jesus, that we know to seek you and that we know how to seek you. Lord, guide us and lead us that we would become intercessors for those around us, for the government, for our leaders. Lord, lead us, Lord Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen. Have a great day.